Hello friends, and welcome to my channel Technical Education to solve technical problems. In this video we are going to adjust the valve clearance on 3 cylinder Perkins engine, Perkins 1103. If you want to learn the process, watch the complete video. The engine firing order is 1, 2, 3. The valve lash setting for inlet valve is 0.20 mm or 0.008 inch. For the exhaust valve, the valve lash setting is 0.45 mm or 0.018 inch. In the first round, we will adjust number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust valve and number 3 cylinder intake valve. With number 1 cylinder at TDC compression stroke, we will adjust number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust and number 3 cylinder intake valve. On the front of the engine is intake valve, next to it is exhaust, and then intake, exhaust, and then intake and exhaust valve. That is the exhaust valve of number 3 cylinder. When number 3 cylinder exhaust valve is fully open, number 1 cylinder is at TDC compression stroke. Remember, number 1 cylinder is on the front of the engine where the timing gear or the fan is, radiator fan is installed. This is number 4 cylinder exhaust valve and it's fully open. This is the intake valve of number 3 cylinder and the valve clearance for intake valve is 0.20 mm. Loose the lock nut, of the adjuster, and then adjust the valve clearance. After adjusting the valve clearance, lock the lock nut again. That is the thick gauge, the 0.45 mm, and that is the exhaust valve of number 1 cylinder. Although we can adjust number 2 cylinder exhaust valve with these three, but we will adjust it in the second round so that 3 valve will be adjusted in one round. The important point for the valve adjustment is to feel the dragging movement on the feeler gauge between the valve stem and the rocker arm. If you can feel the dragging movement, you can adjust the valve clearance very easily. Now we have adjusted number 1 cylinder intake and exhaust and number 3 cylinder intake valve. With number 3 cylinder exhaust valve fully open, and it means that number 1 cylinder is at TDC compression stroke. Now we will rotate the engine 360 degree counterclockwise. If we are looking at our flywheel, and we will bring number 1 cylinder at valve overlap condition. Valve overlap condition is when your exhaust valve is closing and the intake valve is just open. Here you can see exhaust valve is almost closed and intake valve is opening. Here you can see again, by moving back and forth our crankshaft, our intake and exhaust valve are moving back and forth simultaneously. It means that number 1 cylinder is at TDC exhaust stroke or in valve overlap condition. Now we will adjust the remaining 3 tappet or number. The remaining 3 tappets are number 2 cylinder intake and exhaust and number 3 cylinder exhaust valve. This is the intake valve of number 2 cylinder. The valve clearance for the intake valve is 0.20 mm. Practice the dragging movement on the feeler gauge to bring the perfection in the technique of valve adjustment. There is a method to adjust the valve clearance on 3.Perkins 3 cylinder engine with the firing order 1, 2, 3, or any cylinder with the firing order, whether it's John Deere or Perkins or any other engine. You can adjust with the same technique. This is the exhaust valve of number 2 cylinder. The thick gauge is for exhaust valve 0.45 mm. Don't forget to lock the lock nut after adjustment and then recheck the setting. Before installing the camshaft gear, if you have removed it or before removing, loose all the lock nuts and adjusters. At the time you are installing the rocker arm shaft, your push rods will not be damaged if you have loosened the lock nuts and the adjusters. That is the final number 6 valve we are adjusting, the exhaust valve of number 3 cylinder. As you can see on the feeler gauge, it's 0.45 mm. This is Perkins BK 1103 engine, Perkins 1100 series. Thanks for watching the video. Subscribe the channel for more videos like that.